There's news just coming in. The CBI has filed an application in the special court seeking to drop ex-Maharashtra Chief Minister Ashok Chavan's name as an accused in the Aadharsh scam. So the cover-up in the Aadharsh Housing Society scam is complete. The only person who actually had to shoulder any responsibility was Ashok Chavan, former Maharashtra Chief Minister. The others had been given a virtual clean sheet by the Maharashtra Cabinet. Remember, earlier, the Aadharsh Committee report had been dismissed by the Maharashtra government. It had not been tabled in the Maharashtra Assembly. After the intervention of Rahul Gandhi, finally, that report was tabled. And even then, the NCP ministers involved, the current Home Minister Sushil Kumar Shinde, another former Chief Minister of Maharashtra hailing from the Congress, all of them had been given a clean chit. Only Ashok Chavan, for allegedly the favours that his relatives received in exchange for certain favours that he showed, the Aadharsh Society had to shoulder some blame. And now we are learning that an application has been filed by the CBI in the special court seeking to drop the name of Ashok Chavan as an accused in this entire scam. Sahil Joshi, Mumbai Bureau Chief, now joins us on that story. How does the Maharashtra government and the CBI explain this move? Because the allegations that will be levelled at them are that of a complete cover-up in the other scam, Sahil.
But it was bound to happen because CBI was denied permission to prosecute Ashok Chavan by the governor of Maharashtra because they had to take permission from the governor of Maharashtra, and the Maharashtra governor found that CBI do not have enough evidence to prosecute Ashok Chavan, though the charge sheet was filed against him in the CBI court. So after weighing all the legal aspects of the case, it looks like that the CBI finally decided to file application in the special court to remove the charges from the charge sheet against, especially against Ashok Chavan.
But anyway, as far as Ashok Chavan is concerned, even the government, though it had not tried to shield him, had questioned the very locus standi of the CBI in prosecuting him, Sahil.
See, actually, what the government had taken stand when Ashok Chavan was implicated in Aadharsh Commission report, especially on two counts about quid pro quo and giving permission to the Aadharsh Society for the extra FSI. Now, as far as that is concerned, the Maharashtra government stance is that there is already one FIR against Ashok Chavan, and there cannot be two FIRs against one person. So as CBI is already investigating the case, they have filed an FIR, they have filed a charge sheet. So the government from their side is not going to do anything against Ashok Chavan. But now, when the CBI has decided not to move ahead with the charge sheet against Ashok Chavan because the governor did not give them permission, now we'll have to see and check whether what the government takes stand on this. If they agree with the CBI, then the Maharashtra government will also not go ahead with their side of criminal case against Ashok Chavan. But it definitely right now looks like that Ashok Chavan has got a great relief because CBI has decided not to move to the higher court against the governor's decision, because there were rumors that CBI might go to the Supreme Court to get the permission for the prosecution, but it looks like that they're not going to go ahead with that.
Why hasn't the CBI actually gone ahead with that application, Sahil?
See, what the sources in CBI are saying that when the government governor denied them the permission, it looks like that even if the charge sheet has been filed, it will be difficult for them to go forward with the trial against Ashok Chavan because they do not have enough evidence. As we have seen in the Aadharsh Commission report, the Commission's report clearly mentions that though there is no direct evidence against Ashok Chavan, but it is very difficult to deny that the flats which were given to Ashok Chavan's relatives, and he had no idea about that. The fact itself is very difficult to digest, and that is the reason why they have put forward the point saying that Aadharsh Society received the political patronage from then Chief Minister and the Revenue Minister Ashok Chavan. But as far as CBI is concerned, Ashok Chavan was one of the main accused. So to continue with the trials, they needed to support it with proper evidence.
Okay.
The conspirator in the whole scam, Kanhai Lal Gidwani, has died. Mm. So any which way, the main conspirator is no more in the case. Mm. So it looks like that the CBI's case had got weak, and finally they decided not to go ahead with the charge sheet.
Sahil, just stay on with me because a former IPS officer, YP Singh, is also with us on the phone line. Your first reaction now that Mr. Ashok Chavan is also likely to be dropped from the accused list, that's at least what the application filed by the CBI in the special court asks for, Mr. YP Singh.
When the CBI had filed the charge sheet and the way they had violated the CBI manual, where Ashok Chavan, despite being a public servant, they filed the charge sheet without the mandatory sanction to prosecute, it had become apparent that there was a conspiracy to weaken the case so that ultimately Ashok Chavan goes out. And now when the governor has refused sanction to prosecute under Section 19 of the Prevention of Corruption Act, till the time there is a valid sanction to prosecute, the court cannot take any cognizance. So the pre-planned conspiracy of the CBI is now showing its final result, whereby Ashok Chavan's name is being dropped. Perhaps what the CBI is doing is at the instance of their political bosses.
But the sources within the CBI are telling headlines today, Mr. YP Singh, that there wasn't enough evidence against Ashok Chavan to proceed against him. And in that situation, the hands were practically tied. The trial itself would have been infructuous.
No, I think this is absolutely, it's a pretext which is being created by the CBI. It's just a smoke screen. It's a red herring. Because what exactly here is that the case in CBI is generally proved by documents, and here the documentary evidence is overwhelming in nature. Ashok Chavan was the revenue minister in charge of all land allotments. He facilitated the allotment later on when he was chief minister. He granted certain floor space index which was not available, whereby certain more floors were added to the building, and at the time when his own very close and near relatives were the members of the society. What else, what was required to be proved? And there were a series of violations of law which have been duly inferred by the Adarsh Commission. When there is so much of overwhelming evidence and the CBI is disregarding it as saying that the evidence has become weak, it is nothing but an exercise to befool the gullible public.
Mr. YP Singh, final question, and this is about the legal situation that Ashok Chavan now finds himself in. Barring an intervention of the special court where they refuse to entertain the plea by the CBI, essentially Mr. Chavan is in the clear, he'll be off the hook?
I think Mr. Chavan may be off the hook for some time, because there is a legal bar under Section 19 of the Prevention of Corruption Act. Till there is a sanction by the competent authority to prosecute, he cannot be prosecuted. But perhaps once the term of the Vidhan Sabha gets over and he no longer would be a public servant, a retired public servant or a former public servant, for him sanction is not required. So perhaps if he doesn't come get elected again in the elections and he ceases to be a public servant, he can be hauled up in the court of law and prosecuted under the same sections of law which CBI is dropping at the moment.
Do you suspect that this is a cover-up that has been effected by the Congress? All the others are already in the clear as far as the Adarsh Commission report is concerned and the response of the Maharashtra government to it. Ashok Chavan was the only one who was being called a fall guy, and now chances are even he may be in the clear very soon.
Yes, exactly. He would be absolutely out of the soon, but I say out of the case soon. But I think the public pressure and the evidence in this case is so overwhelming in nature that this reprieve may be temporary. And later on, either there would be a sanction forthcoming, or if he ceases to be a servant, public servant, either way, I think he may face the prosecution in the times to come.
Thank you very much, YP Singh, for joining us. In fact, BJP leader Shaina NC also is with us on the phone line from Mumbai. Shaina NC, what does this say about the entire way in which the Congress government in Maharashtra and the investigating agencies have reacted to the Adarsh report? Ashok Chavan, a plea has been filed by the CBI in the special court asking that his name be dropped from the list of accused.
Well, when we talk about the misuse of the CBI, clearly it's ample in this case. If one only goes into the details of the Adarsh scam, one knows that the biggest culprit is the former Chief Minister Ashok Chavan. Now, if the CBI chooses to give him a clean chit despite a judicial report which has cost 7 to 8 crores, I think we as an opposition are entitled to term the CBI as the Congress Bureau of Investigation. This kind of political manipulation and this kind of blatant cover-up for people in positions of power is something that the Congress party needs to reply and retort on. The public of Maharashtra is not going to take this lying down. And despite the various kinds of agitations, this government is so thick-skinned that time and again we have seen misuse of power and misuse of agencies through the government in power.
So what is the opposition going to do about it? Because despite your vehement protests, the Adarsh Commission report was accepted only in part by the Maharashtra government.
Well, let me please remind you that it is only because of the BJP's intervention that this issue was even stalled. The point is, when this report had come into the assembly, there was a huge section within the Congress, and obviously for vested interests, who did not want to have any part of this judicial probe accepted. It is because of the agitation of the opposition that we were in a position to even bring the guilty to dock. And now with the CBI kind of giving a blatant cover-up to Mr. Ashok Chavan, this is nothing but manipulation of the system. And we will appeal, we will go to the courts, we will agitate on the streets, and we will do whatever is required.
All right, China NC, thank you very much for your reaction to the story that we are breaking right now on Headlines Today.